sheshe. Shita ya lofa. Spina lofa. Drifta drifta wa lofada. Awushi tutu. Wozo borna bushitaya.
Where are the white folks in the spinning world?
I don't know. I actually don't know why they haven't actually got into it.
Hearing rumors, you know, going to visit the boys there in Tickle's Wrist, that Vaaitjie's got a corner there. And I said, a corner for what? No, we call it Vaaitjie Kunene's corner. I said, okay. So one afternoon I went through and see, oh, this is where he's learning to burn tires.
Yes.
Yeah, because, and then it was not second-hand tires, it was the new tires.
Ah,
you see?
There we go.
Yeah. So then I went there one day and I saw the guys there teaching him how to spin on the tar road.
Yeah, my mother asked, why, what are you doing? I said, no, start spinning. So yeah, they accepted it and yeah, they're one of my main sponsors now. So my parents, they sponsor me a lot, so that is my main sponsor because everybody's giving all the other people sponsors because they think I'm not good enough. Well, I don't compare it with people. I do it for the love of the game. I like just to do things for the crowd.
But Vaaitjie, when someone says you're not good enough, according to you, what makes a spinner a good spinner?
Well, all spinners, I say there's no good spinner.
Yeah.
You must entertain your crowd.
Every time when I'm spinning, I took some videos, I watch my videos, I'm learning from my videos and I'm taking. Try to do something different to get the crowd to be happy. Yeah, the adrenaline is very, very, how can I say, high in the blood pressure now. It's very exciting to do this sport.
Spinning in the, this is not actually my game, it's, how can I say, it's for the colors and the blacks.
Do you think we're racist?
No.
Not anymore.
Spinning, it's a lifestyle. It's nice to meet some cultures, work with the people. It brings us together as friends. There's no color difference here. We all enjoy the sport and we do what we can to entertain the crowd.
Racist in this game.
Okay.
Because I'm gonna come to your location if you're racist or not. Everybody says it's for the criminals.
Do you believe that?
No, I don't believe that because then I will also be a criminal because I like this. This is, you do it for the adrenaline rush.
My best friends, black guys, colored guys, I grew up mostly with in the Model C schools, so I was friends with them. No gangsterism and all of us were good buddies, we were legal buddies, we are against gangsterism actually. And I'm married to an African woman myself, so it's easy for me to mix with them. It's not a problem.
Basically, Intersenza, about it before, it was a gangster sport. Manje, I see Guti is sport, Guti is over gangsterized. This thing is becoming commercial, it's becoming a sport. Teenagers, they are motivated about it. During the show, they are motivated about it. They are motivated about spinner in a place that's made for spinning and is used for spinning. And we're not doing it illegally. I'm a police corner, I'm a security corner, everything is tight.
Thank you.
And now where I'm staying in Escort, we have a facility where we can practice and entertain people.
I also work for my parents, and so I have a salary that I get. Well, work on trucks, yeah, with diesel mechanic, and my mother has this resort, just doing weddings and functions. And my father supplies all the building materials and things. So yeah, we work on the trucks and things. Then I also spend my own money on fuel. If we go to events, yeah, you spend that out of your own pocket. It's getting expensive.
Yes.
And even the people at the tires, they're starting to charge us 5 rand, 10 rand a tire for a second. And so yeah, this game is getting expensive.
Is this something that you want to do outside of spinning? Are you studying something?
I'm not studying. Just spinning. I love for spinning.
So this is something.
This is like my work. This is, you see, in my own backyard. There's my house, my room. I stay there. So yeah, if I in the mornings when I wake up, I walk into this. This is my living life. What I do every day. Well, as a spinner, you must always have some extra blocks, cranks, intakes. You always need something extra. So yeah, this is my storeroom where I keep my extra space. So whenever something goes wrong, I always run to here, see if I can find something that's gonna work. So yeah, you must always have extra ability to do it. I don't abuse girls or nothing, it's just friends, yeah, just enjoying life. Like I said, you only live once.
Spina Guluva. Spina Guluva.
Was it easy for you to build a truck like this?
Yeah, we had some more input of the guys that know how to do it. Yeah. Well, there was not a lot of tracks available, really, because the venues, you know, when they started, were not a lot. Now, at least, there's a few venues that they see what they can use.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is interesting, because according to the findings through the show, I've been feeling as if motorsports is not completely part of spinning. I feel like the spinning guys are on their own. So you're giving me a different light here.
You do not see much of motorsport involved in the spinning, especially at spinning events.
Yes.
The COC, who's the clerk of the course, and the MSA steward, who's there, who's representing motorsport, are at the events, but you don't actually see them. We only get involved if anything happens that shouldn't happen. If it's not according to the rules and the regs, then motorsport will get involved. Right at this point in time, what they are doing, and if they are doing the rules and the regs and what they have specified on their log documentation to motorsport, everything is fine. We don't get involved. We watch it and see that it goes on.
We did go through all the regulations of MSA Motorsport South Africa. Yeah, there were yet some events. And like I said, I like to do everything on point. And like you can see, my pitch, everything is safe. So yeah, we did do all this. And yeah, MSA is costly. It costs you a lot of money. But the safety and all the things that involves of MSA, you benefit on that eventually.
Okay, but can I ask you, what are the complications? What would make them, like, not do the right thing? Do you know what I mean?
What happens there is a lot of the times during the event, you get people that now want to do the illegal stuff, is what we call it, because they're so hyped up.
Yeah.
Motorsport then actually stops the event and says motorsport cannot get involved any further now, because the people that are coming in have either had one or too many to drink, which we do not allow.
Yeah.
But because they've had it and they get aggro when you do not want to get them involved, motorsport then takes a back seat. And then it doesn't become a motorsport event anymore. Then it becomes just an event that's happening at the track at the time.
Nothing went wrong on our events yet. So because your first money that you make on the gate is basically MSA.
Of course.
The problem that we have is everybody that works for motorsport, except those that work in the office, mm-hmm. are actually volunteers. So we all volunteer our time, and sometimes we get a bit of remuneration for that.
Yeah.
Sometimes we don't.
Yeah.
But we all volunteer our time. Me sitting with you now is my own
time.
Time.
Yeah.
All right. Me going to an event, going to do a track inspection.
Yeah.
All I do at that track inspection, I say, just reimburse my expenses. Mm. I don't ask them for money to do this.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
that's the issues that we have.
Okay.
We need from our side. I think there needs to be a bit of education from the public
yeah.
to go to the people who are on the ground, right? Wheels and Smoke,
yes.
which is Monday,
yes.
right? Bullet, and then get the information from them and how to go about it. Once they've got it there, they come to us.
Because they're examples of how it's done and they did it.
Exactly that.
And you have your marshals. It's not like all the other sports. Okay, yeah, you must check your battery. It's logic to do all that. You must do that. So yeah, they come here, they assign your things, see if your car is ready, and then you spin.
Yeah.
It's not like the dragsters where you need all the safety harnesses.
Yes.
Yeah, that. So it's actually a waste of MSA just being here. You waste your own money actually.
Mm.
So yeah, but luckily MSA is not on our case yet. So. Yeah. Away, and because everybody was friends before,
yes,
there was this, everybody was sitting together, everybody was chilling together at the events. Now it's this one, okay, he has a sponsor now, what, he's sitting there,
yes,
other one is sitting there, so they're starting to get into each other's, the edge is getting too big.
The thing is, competition is a good thing. You can't play to one side. Kaiser Chiefs and Pirates can't play to one goal. What's the interesting thing about sports? There must be competition. In business, in everything, there's competition. But good competition is one thing, but bad is another thing. But I think we make a great team here in Poch, and there's no problem around that.
If you were speaking to the minister, like Fikile Mbalula, you know our minister of sports, what would you say to him about spinning? Because I feel like he knows about the spinning world, but he's not really passionate, he's not really in it. As someone that's, I don't want to say you knew in the spinning world, but someone of color, of your skin tone, what would you like to say to him about spinning?
Well, I would like to say he's missing on something. He's missing on a passionate thing that people love, starting to, okay, there's a lot of people starting to love the game,
yes.
all the youngsters. So he must just not think about himself that's not liking spinning. There's white, black, colored, Indian, everybody likes spinning. So he must start accepting it and make, he must, the people's needs, he must start looking into people's needs.
Yes.
Everybody wants spinning now because it's starting to get fuller, places getting more, the adrenaline, the
yeah.
people are starting to feel it. So yeah, he must start looking into it. And well, if he wants to feel adrenaline rush, he's more than welcome to come spin with me. I'll give him a nice adrenaline rush.
Yes, he will.
Yeah, and I will convince him.
Yeah.
Maybe I will try my best to convince him. This is Warren, little man. He was a small boy when I was growing up, so it's Warren, little man. He's one of my stunts. And then I have Chip a Dip. This is the crazy one. He did a tight, he tapped it a bit loosey on his head. Yeah, and this, Dennis James, he's unfortunately can't be here, but it's my stuntman also. And yeah, we love the spinning.
What's the thrill with the seat? Like, you sit on it,
yes.
You're buckled up,
yes.
And then
my line goes into spin. When it goes into spin, and I just get it.
It's like the adrenaline rush.
I can't even explain it because
you can't explain it.
Yeah.
But
it's amazing how it feels.
But just sit there and make pretty faces enjoying yourself, like Vaaitjie Kunene spinning there.
Yeah.
Make the people laugh for it.
What? So you get in the booth?
I lay down there. If I just spell to me, spell to me, then don't you stand till they come out.
Please show me, please show me. Okay, without the spell. Yeah. So you jump in. Wait a minute, are you here when it starts or do you jump in?
He's already in the booth.
Yes. Okay, like
yeah.
Did you also invent this one?
Yes.
You crazy chip and dip. You're crazy. So you're in there?
Yes.
Ah, there we go. So they don't know that you're there?
No, no one knows. Before we go in, he's already in the booth.
Okay.
He has his hand fully in here, so if he taps here,
yeah,
we know he's ready.
Then I come out.
So you need to go there, that way, for him to come out this way?
In the spin. And then I lock the spin. If the car locks, yeah, while the wheels are spinning, he gets under the smoke, creates a nice effect. So he gets out and jumps up and then...
To people, to get mad.
It's crazy!
How can I say, just living free and just enjoying life, because you only live once.
Sure.
So you must enjoy life, you must do exciting things in life that can build your passions and make something of you. So you must start somewhere.
We like to get them out of drugs and, you know, mischievous stuff. So I think it's a good sport. It's a good sport to attract people. Motorsport, when stuff is making big noises, the people always enjoy it.
We are against drugs.
Yeah.
We love together, socialize together.
Yes.
And I said thanks to Vaaitjie and his parents, because I'm staying now here 2 years.
Wow.
Working here.
Yeah.
I said thanks to God, you pray every day.
Yes.
And I hope God bless the parents, for the brother to grow for, and for us, Vaaitjie.
Yes.
I also just want to say thank you to Vaaitjie and his parents, and because Vaaitjie helps me with a lot of things.
For me, you're doing like a bit of a zen. A zen moment.
Yeah, we can say thank you.
What is that? Who are you thanking?
I'm thanking the Lord for this, and then get back into my car, and the adrenaline rush, everything, thanks.
The crowd goes mental when you do that.
I like to communicate with my crowd, and if you see, I'm just like, thank you.
It's a beautiful moment.
I enjoy it. Spina Guluva, the man that just does everything and enjoy life. I'm an adrenaline freak, and everybody knows it. Where I go, if I go to spinning events with my motorbike, they know I must always do something for them. Yeah, so it's always an adrenaline rush. Where I go, people knows me as Spina Guluva. You can see as my Suzuki GSR 1000, nothing smaller than 1000. I can't do something smaller than 1000. Still standard. Nice Yoshi pipe on here, and that's all I standard. Then I have my 3-5 Stachler here that I spin, just port gas flow and management, Duffy slop. We call it a cup, Mark, one you'll still see on events, but yeah, it's also strong, nice, powerful. I've got the heated dirty box BMW. I put it a Lexus Toyota V8 engine in it. I'm still sorting the engine out, still a little bit of problems that I'm sorting out. So, but it's running fine. And then me and my stunt band, we're still learning each other, doing stunts that we need to do to keep the community happy.
So this is a Nissan RB25 turbocharged engine from the factory. So I did some aftermarket things on it. I put a bigger turbo on, I put an aftermarket, this is the turbo aftermarket wastegate. So it wastes some of your boost, so it doesn't run away. You set the boost to a certain standard to make certain power engines. I put bigger injectors this side to fuel the engine so it performs properly. I put a performance intake manifold on there, so the flow on the turbo engine is better. I put the R33 Skyline radiator in to do the cooling system, and I've got a front mount intercooler on it as well. But in future I'm going to put some methanol injection on it as well to cool down the engine and up the performance so I can be longer on the pitch. Because it generates a lot of power and it generates a lot of heat. It's currently on 314 kilowatts.